To import well data into Insight, select Import Well Data. Well data can be an Insight recognized format, LAS or generic text files. For this first example, I will import an OWX file, otherwise known as an OpenWorks export file. Because OWX is recognized by Insight, multiple components of the well can be imported simultaneously, with little user configuration making it the most efficient option to import well data. Simply select the OWX file and open it. OWX can contain well paths, check shots, curves, and markers. Choose which objects you want to import. Insight will suggest the most likely units, datums, and positional information of the incoming data. You can change these values if they're not as expected. Click on OK to proceed with loading, and I am prompted with an opportunity to change the CRS of the incoming data. The imported data will be converted to match the CRS of the project. I can check the pop-up for a summary of the imported data objects and look for any warnings or errors from the incoming data. The map view shows the well is in the correct location, which is always a good start. Because a complete set of well data has been loaded, I will use the well in single well view to QC the results. Switching between MDKB and TVDSS shows the well path is correct, and switching to two-way time is a QC for the time depth table. Increasing the defined projection distance to 1000 meters makes the well appear on the seismic section. At the same time, I can adjust the thickness and color of the wellbore. Data not formatted for Insight can be imported as separate data types and requires more configuration. In this second example, I will select a generic ASCII well header file to get started. I can specify well header as the input data type before configuring the import parameters. Configuring the parameters is just a case of describing the file format and data positions. This file is comma delimited, and so I can select a comma to identify the different columns of data. Insight has already recognized that the first column is probably a well name and assigned it accordingly. The second column can be assigned as UWI, the unique well identifier. The UWI is essential to match different components of the well when importing. The third column can be assigned as an onshore or offshore indicator through the drop-down selector. The next column is a well elevation, or calibration, and after that there is water depth, listed as elevation. If there is data in the file with no matching attribute in Insight, I can leave the drop-down selector blank to ignore the column. The remaining attributes, such as X and Y, can be assigned along the total depth. Notice that Insight has automatically detected and assigned the well status, making it as easy as possible to format these files. Click OK to complete the formatting. Check the import summary for any problems or warnings. Double-click on the well to open the Configure Well dialog and QC the well header just imported. Any additional data files that do not contain the UWI must be loaded individually to the well using this window. Click on the Path tab. Notice that a straight well path already exists, because a total depth and XY coordinates were supplied as part of the well header import. Click on the New Well Path button. Give the well path a name and select a deviated path type. Select the File to Import button and configure the import parameters. Insight has detected headers and assigned most of the columns correctly, but I can change the settings if required. I can also change the units and the datum from which the measurements have been made. Once again, I can select the CRS of the incoming data and convert to the project coordinate system as required. Once imported, set the new well path to default for it to be used by Insight. Click on the TD Pairs tab and click on the New Time Depth Chart button. Select the File to Import button. Select the file and then give the TD table a name. Configure the import parameters. Insight has again detected headers and assigned most of the columns correctly, but I can change the settings if required. In this example, I'm going to load the check shot using TVD instead of MD. I can also change the units and the datum from which the measurements have been made. Click on OK to import the data, and it now appears on the two-way time section because it has time depth conversion needed to display. I can change the display parameters such as the choice of curve, but at this point I only have time depth and velocity information. I can also change the path color and thickness. Click on the Markers tab and click on the New Marker Table button. Select the File to Import button and select the marker file. The file name is assigned to the marker table name if you do not directly specify one. Configure the import parameters, check the datums and columns are assigned correctly, and click on OK to import the data. QC results in the data views that are open. Finally, click on the Well Curves tab and click on the New Log Curve Set button. Select the File to Import button and select the log curve file. Last file formats are recognized by InSight and need no special configuration. The data is loaded. Close the Configure Well dialog and QC results using Section View and Single Well View. Switch from two-way time to MDKB to TVDSS to check the time depth tables and well paths have been loaded correctly.
If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with InSight!